Gopinath was, to say the least, a confirmed miser. To him, money was akin to the very godliness of Lakshmi, the goddess of wealth. It should be handled with care and respect. A bundle of currency was like God's image in a shrine, only to be contemplated. The notion that money was meant to be spent was just nonsense.
Piece of those Mysore sweets to test. Only as a sample, mind you. Not good.
Gopinath even denied himself all pleasures of human contacts so that his safe would remain undisturbed. Every morning, he would savor his garden of delights, the lint of a 100-rupee note, the dull color of the 10, and the green of the 5s, and so on, never disturbing the composition and visual rhythm they engendered. 10 years ago, his wife's illness had made her quite senile, and she constantly summoned a doctor at 10 rupees a visit.
Doctor, doctor, I need a doctor badly. Please call the doctor.
Again? Doctor, doctor, he was here just 2 weeks ago.
Gopinath had no trust in doctors. After all, they were not gods. What was the point in consulting an expensive physician and prolonging life? Moreover, it was vexing to hear the doctor repeat every time after a cursory examination and pocketing 10 rupees.
But she's anemic. Why don't you give her plenty of fruits and proteins?
Fruits and proteins indeed. Doesn't the doctor know that you can't get any fruit for less than 6 rupees a kilo? He probably gets them free from imposing on his patients.
Yeah. Fruits for you. Eat them.
When his wife died, Gopinath was grief-stricken at first, like all widowers, mind you. But in course of time, he began to feel a sly satisfaction. No doubt on the money saved on doctor's bills and fruits. Fruits indeed. After the funeral, Gopinath warned the priest, in no uncertain terms,
Whatever has happened. God's will. Only simple and essential rites are to be performed within 20 rupees. I will not spare a paisa more. Is that clear?
The only human contact the miser permitted was his only child and daughter, Parvati, who would come over to look after him every few days. With her, unfortunately, came his 10-year-old grandson, who jumped and danced on his only sofa set, spoiling its springs. He had acquired the sofa for some 60 rupees, and if the grandson kept his distance, there was some chance of selling it for 200 rupees, or so Jayaraj, the photo frame maker, said. But this boy... The boy also constantly demanded money for sweets. Sweets are bad for the teeth, and Gopinath didn't want the young fellow to damage them at such an early age and then pay the dentist for the folly. The little fellow was really proving irksome.
Grandpa, Grandpa!
What is it?
Please give me a rupee for sweets.
Here.
Only 10 paisa?
That's enough. Go now. Go.
Father, please listen to me. This place is falling apart. Why don't you get it repaired?
Parvati, ancestral property should never be tampered with. Do you know how much it would cost to get this house repaired? It serves my purpose. You look after your house.
Grandpa, I want 3 rupees.
Again? Why?
I need to stock up my pencil box. 3 rupees for a sharpener, eraser and pencils.
No.
Please, Grandpa, please.
Pencils and sweets, sweets and pencils? What happens to all your pencils? Do you chew them up with your sweets? Nothing doing, get out.
No. Don't cry. After all, if your grandfather scolds you, it's for your own good, isn't it? You mustn't take it to heart. Now wipe off those tears and be a good boy.
A few days later, however, Gopinath felt like atoning for his severity. But the thought of spoiling the composition of the cash bundles for loose money was a disturbing one. And then he saw it. A 10-rupee note lying loose at the bottom of the safe. The stray one seemed to be an alien, not belonging to the close-knit family in neat bundles. He remembered that the temple priest had paid quarterly interest, and he'd casually tossed the note in. It was second-generation cash which Gopinath did not mind spending. So he took it from the safe and decided to give the child a treat.
Ravi!
Oh, Father, what a surprise. Do come in.
Yes. Thought I would drop by for a while. Ah, young man, free for the day? No program? Come, let's go to a picture.
Father, you? A picture?
Yes, me. Come on, I'll dress him up quickly now. Come. Parvati, will you hurry up? Paying for the ticket, we don't want to miss the beginning, do we?
Grandpa, which film are we going to?
Which film are we going to? Let me assure you, it's a very good film, full of gods and witchcraft and demons. Besides, it's showing at the Central Theatre.
Oh no, let us go to the Palace Theatre.
No, the Central is better.
Oh no, You don't get ice creams there.
Oh Ravi, don't argue with your grandfather. He knows what is best. Come on now.
Come.
Be good and don't trouble your grandfather. Hmm?
Chocolates are bad for your teeth.
But Grandpa... Grandpa, ice cream.
Ice cream is bad for the throat.
But Grandpa...
Grandfather naturally preferred the Central because it was within walking distance and saved on unnecessary rickshaw fare. The palace displayed unwanted luxury and put it all onto the ticket buyer. After all, it was only for a couple of hours, and who wanted plush seats? One was not going to spend one's life in the theater, was one? While enjoying a picture, one must not be fussy about the surroundings. No, that would be a waste of time and money.
Grandpa, Grandpa, let us go to Palace Theater. We can have ice cream cones there. Please, Grandpa.
No, I told you not to pester me with your demands. Now keep quiet and let's enjoy our outing.
Grandpa, Grandpa, let's go to Palace. This film has very good fights in it. Please, Grandpa.
₹3 tickets and ₹4 back.
Grandpa, Grandpa, I want the soda with the marble in it.
Don't you have any value for money? The film has already started. Come, come on, fast. Come, come. Can't you sit still in a film even?
I'm thirsty, Grandpa.
Thirsty? We have just come here and you're thirsty. Wait for some time. You can drink water at home.
Hey, you two. Will you keep quiet? Or do you want me to come and shut your mouth?
Shut your mouth. On the floor. Come and sit here.
No.
Ravi, can you see the film from there?
Yes, Grandpa. I can see everything. It's great fun.
Should never bring this boy out again. Most wasteful trip.
What? Who is it?
Go back to sleep.
put it in the board. That's the
తమరెవరు?
నేను విష్ణు శర్మ అనే పండితుడను. నేర్చిన విద్యలను దాచుకున్న నేరానికి నా గురుదేవులు నన్ను ఒక భయంకర పిశాచివి కమ్మని శపించారు. ఆ పిశాచి తినేసేదా అని ముమ్మారు.
ఎవరైతే Did you see a small boy coming out of the hall? His name is Ravi.
No, it has been bad enough having to keep an eye on hundreds of devils trying to sneak into the hall all day long.
Could you please make an announcement in the hall?
What? And stop the film? The audience will kill me. This is the best part. The snake is going to swallow the heroine. Hurry up, get in.
Please try to understand. My grandson is missing. He's been kidnapped.
Is that so? How will an announcement in the hall help you? Are the kidnappers inside the hall? I doubt it. They must be miles off by now.
Worried as he was, Gopinath did not want to miss the scene of the snake swallowing the heroine. After all, there was no point in wasting a second ticket, was there? Though all had ended well and good had prevailed over evil, the thought of his missing grandson troubled him no end, and so Gopinath set off in search.
Oh my God, how could I be so careless? Kidnapped from a theater full of people? And that too, under my very nose? I better inform the police. Excuse me, No, that would be useless. They will make demands now. Ransom. 50,000 rupees? Oh my God, there is bound to be a note at my door demanding the money. But I won't pay them. Not a single paisa. What am I saying? Of course I'll pay it. Ravi, I'm sorry, my boy. So sorry for having ill-treated you. I should have listened to you when you wanted to go to the palace theater. This wouldn't have happened then. But what am I going to say to Parvati? What can I tell her? She'll be heartbroken. She loves the child. Naturally, he's their only one. No. I must pay the ransom.
Mr. Gopinath, will you take some Mysore sweets home? Fresh and warm. Made of the purest ghee and sugar. Shall I pack half a kilo?
Half a kilo.
What do you think money grows on? Trees? Well, how much does a kilo cost?
Only 25 rupees a kilo. That would be 12.50 for half. Shall I pack a quarter kilo?
No, 50 grams will do.
Fifth?
Only 25 rupees a kilo. Only 25. Put the word only before any figure and people think it sounds cheap. Well, I'm not one of those. You can't fool me.
Go Gopinath did not believe in squandering money on guards either. But this was a special case.
God, save my grandson. Please, I promise to offer you a coconut if he's all right. A full coconut.
Father, you look very tense. Did Ravi make any mischief?
Huh? Oh, no, no. No, no, not at all. He was as good as gold. At least till...
Till? What do you mean, Father?
Nothing. Nothing.
Shall I bring you some coffee?
What? Yes, please. To break the news to both of them now. Maybe I should have bought some more sweets.
Father?
Huh?
Why don't you stay for dinner, Father? He should be coming back home soon. We can all eat together.
How do I begin? Parvati? Parvati, what have I done?
What is it, Father? Have your coffee.
I don't deserve this coffee.
What's the matter?
Parvati, your son.
What, Father? What happened?
Nothing. You can't blame him, really. It was all my fault. I was so engrossed in the film that...
Mother, we won the match! We won the game! We won the game! We won the game!
Ravi? Come here, Ravi. What mischief have you been up to?
No, Parvati. Please, not a word to the boy. Ravi, my boy... Where have you been? Thank God you're safe. Did they trouble you?
Who, Grandpa?
No. Where have you been, my child?
Playing cricket. I suddenly remembered I had a match. So I had to go.
Good. So you won the match. Good. There's nothing to worry about now.
What's in the packet, Grandpa?
This? Some sweets for your mother. For you.
Me?
Ravi? Don't eat it now. After dinner.
Yes, Mother.
Come in, Father.
Parvati!
What is it?
Do you know the price of a coconut these days?